Well, I've been asked by a gentleman that's taken this recording to just say who I am. Well, I'm generally known as Old Fred of Horsted Keynes Station. Why they call me old, I don't know. I'm only between 60 and 70, but it's not very old, you know. However, I've been on this station a few years now, and everyone seems to know me, and I know most of the people that come here. Except, of course, now, weekends, we're getting strangers from all over the country for this famous Bluebell line. And, of course, it adds a little life to the station. And we're asked all sorts of wonderful questions. You tell people exactly where to go and what to do, and then they come back 10 minutes later and say, oh, what was it you said? Well, now you asked me about how the Bluebell Railways came into operation. Having seen the old Lewis East Grinstead line come to a steady close, got resurrected for a short while again by the efforts of Miss Bessemer at Newick and Shaley, a lady I know very well. And then it took an act of Parliament and the full force of the House of Commons to shut it again. And one Sunday morning, I was on duty at this station, Horsted Keynes, and I had a few schoolboys come along. They seemed to be rather interested in how the line ran, and they told me and the signalman that was here that they were going to reopen it. Of course, naturally, we laughed at them. And a little few weeks after that, perhaps, I suppose just a few weeks, a few more people came along with the schoolboys. They seem quite interesting. They seem rather mature men, rather sensible businessmen of the world, but they got bitten by the railway mania. I might say that none of them worked on the railway. And they all started telling us they were going to see into the matter and open it up again. Of course, we laughed more at them. Told them there were plenty of jobs going on the railway if they were so interested in it. Offered to introduce them to our station master. No, they said they meant business, and of course we laughed at them, but eventually there was quite a number got together, and it was a special excursion was organised down to Horsted Keynes one Sunday. A gentleman by the name of Mr. Leroy seemed to be the chief light in it those days, and about the same time there was a Captain Manisty. Don't know now whether he's a naval captain or an army captain. Perhaps if he's army captain, he probably belonged to the railway engineers or something. And Mr. Horace May, they appeared on the scene, and we had instructions at this station to afford them every facility, which was very good of British Railways. And the train duly pulled in, several hundred people on board, beautiful Sunday afternoon. The middle waiting room on the middle platform, that was turned into a buffet and did a roaring trade. And then we thought, well, we don't know whether this is a railway meeting or whether it was a part of the Keswick Convention. Mr. Leroy, it turned out, clambered up the signal gantry, which made a very good pulpit. We quite expected him to open up with Onward Christian Soldiers or something. But then he got to work and all the people clustered round. Took us all the next day to rake the gravel straight on the middle platform. He explained the proposals, and they were all carried, and everyone agreed to subscribe to this wonderful adventure, and eventually they approached British Railways at the top, and British Railways, I suppose, did the same as we did. They laughed at them. Told them they'd want a modest £34,000, and they'd want it quick. They said they'd get it. Much to our astonishment, they got it. And that's how the Bluebell Railway started. Now the blighters are carrying more passengers in a day than we normally carry in a week.